In Outliner, let's select our MetaHuman, then in Details, select Face. In General tab, browse to Face Mesh. Right-click on Face Mesh and go to Asset Actions, Export, Save, Export. Let's select a couple of face textures. Right-click, Asset Actions, Bulk Export, Select Folder. Now go to Common Folder, Male Hair, Textures. Locate Eyelash Texture. Right-click, Asset Actions, Export, Save. Go back to Common Folder. Go to Face, Textures Folder. Locate Iris Textures. Select, right-click, Asset Actions, Bulk Export, Select Folder. Go back to Textures Folder. Select these images, then right-click, Asset Actions, Bulk Export, Select Folder. Let's check what we've exported and tidy up the files. Find the Textures folder, cut it and paste it next to the FBX file. Put Eyelashes texture inside that folder. Navigate to Face folder, cut out face textures and paste them into the Textures folder. We can delete the game folder. Let's import the FBX file into Blender. Hide the bones. Select the head and clear all of the materials. In Edit mode, select and separate the head mesh. Select and delete inside of the mouth. Select back of the eyeballs. Separate and name them Sclera. Now select the front of the eyeballs. Separate and name them Cornea. Let's name this inside. These guys I named AO. These two are tear lines. These two I called eyelids. And the rest are eyelashes. Let's go back to head. Select it and add a material. Go to the shading tab. Let's quickly add the diffuse color map to the head. Unhide the eyelashes. Bring this texture into Blender. We will use its transparency information. Change blend mode to alpha blend and shadow mode to alpha clip or alpha hashed. Change color space to raw and set a base color. Let's make an iris from the cornea. Select cornea and go to the edit mode. Select the tip of the eyeball and grow the selection. Duplicate, then detach the selection and name it iris. It will be easier to work with one iris and then mirror it. So let's delete the other half. MetaHuman's eyeballs stay at an angle. You can see it in the top view. Let's zoom to select it with the period numpad key. Select the vertex in the middle and activate proportional editing. Move along the local Z axis while adjusting proportional threshold with the mouse wheel. Let's open this PNG in an image editor. Flatten the layer. Go to Channels tab and split channels. Now let's save resulting grayscale images. This one I've named Iris Outer. This one is Iris Inner. And this one is Iris Normal. Back in Shading tab, make a new material and name it Iris. Bring all of the newly saved grayscale JPEG images. And also the original one. We will only need the alpha information from this PNG file. Now let's mix inner and outer iris images. Iris normal will be used for height information. If iris texture doesn't look correct, then go to edit mode, select all and unwrap. Add a color ramp node. Set colors to your liking. Here we have several blending modes to choose from. Duplicate color ramp for iris inner and also set its colors. Sorry, not order should be like this. Let's add a displacement node here and adjust height like this. Change blend mode to alpha blend. Okay, cool. Now let's deal with cornea. Add a gradient texture node. While selected, press Ctrl T to add texture coordinate and mapping nodes. If the shortcut doesn't work, enable node wrangler and add-ons. Connect color to transmission. Add a color ramp node in between here. Let's select and delete the other cornea and set origin to geometry. With its origin close to the iris, it will be easier for us to manipulate transparent part of the cornea. Let's narrow the range and set interpolation to ease. Set Z rotation to minus 90 degrees in mapping node and flip black and white flags in color ramp node. Bring the transparent part close enough to the iris, the position of which we will clarify later. Add a mix shader node in between here. Arrange nodes like this. Add a transparent BSDF node in between here. Go to Render Properties and enable Screen Space Reflections and Refraction. Go to Material Properties, Settings, and enable Screen Space Refraction. Choose Alpha Blend as Blend Mode. Uncheck Show Backface. In principled BSDF shader, reduce roughness. Bring veins texture and connect its color output to base color of principled BSDF shader. Now it's time to fix the position of transparent section of the cornea. First, let's select the iris. Go to edit mode and move along the Z axis. Now scale down a bit. Okay, now center the cornea to the iris and adjust location and rotation of transparent section. Okay, not bad. Let's handle the inside. Add a material, set its base color to black and increase its roughness. Now let's work on the tear line. Let's also show the face. Make a new material and name it accordingly. Increase metallic and decrease roughness. Down in settings, enable screen space refraction. Choose alpha hashed for blend mode. Decrease alpha, but not all the way to zero. In render properties, let's increase sampling. About eyelashes. I found out that alpha hashed for blend mode works better. If it's still not dense enough, then duplicate and move it very slightly up or down. When we orbit around, you can notice a problem at the center of the iris. Easy fix would be changing blend mode to opaque. If you want wetter eyes, unhide AO and set its material as tears material. As a final touch, let's add a normal map to the face. Sorry, Majid, but better late than never.